When will the Voyager probes leave the solar system? On November 5, 2018, NASA announced that the Voyager 2 space exploration probe had left the heliopause. This area marks the limit of the solar system, so Voyager 2, along with its sister, Voyager 1, became the only two objects created by humans that have left the solar system. However, many astronomers stress that Voyagers have not yet left the solar system as they remain under the Sun's gravity. So when will the Voyager spacecraft leave the solar system if this is the case? Is that a long time away, or will it be within the next few years? And precisely, what is the limit of the solar system? Where are the Voyagers now? Voyager 2 launched on August 20th, 1977, 16 days before its twin, Voyager 1. But due to a faster route, Voyager 1 reached a significant speed and exited the asteroid belt before its twin, Voyager 2. In 2012, NASA announced that the Voyager 1 had managed to leave what until then was believed to be the limit of the solar system, an area called the heliopause. And then, on November 5, 2018, Voyager 2 would follow suit and also manage to go beyond the heliopause. Until that moment, it was announced that both space exploration probes had managed to leave our solar system. But that changed after the data that the ship sent us from the ends of space were analyzed. Currently, both spacecraft are more than 15,000 million kilometers away from the Sun. But it is a consensus that they have not yet left the solar system, and this is because the solar atmosphere is much larger than we thought. So how big is the solar system? A common mistake in defining whether Voyager probes have left the solar system or not is that it does not establish exactly what the solar system's boundary is. Some mention that the limit is the heliopause, others say that it is the Oort cloud. To understand it better, we must explain the difference between the heliopause and the heliosphere. The heliosphere is a space region under the influence of solar wind and the magnetic field of the Sun. This area is composed of ions from the solar atmosphere and extends beyond the orbit of Pluto. This radiation gives rise to a magnetic bubble surrounding the entire solar system, planets, comets, and asteroids. The heliopause is the boundary or final boundary of the heliosphere that separates the interplanetary medium where the Sun exerts its force. It is the beginning of the interstellar medium where the Sun no longer influences bodies. The problem with these two definitions is that we currently do not know how large the heliosphere covering the solar system is because we have never sent anything so far. Unknown areas of the solar system. Before the Voyager probes, there was an estimate of how much of the heliosphere covered the entire solar system. But as we move outward, we realize that this region is much larger than we imagined. To understand how all the layers surrounding the Sun are constituted, let's travel to the ends of the solar system. Firstly, the heliosphere. This is the one we mentioned earlier, and it is the region where all the planets of the solar system and all the layers surrounding the Sun are located. Then we get to the termination shock front. Beyond the orbit of Pluto, space begins to get more and more empty and cold. As we move away from the Sun, the solar radiation begins to become more and more tenuous, and the energy provided by the Sun's rays is fragile. When the Voyager probes reached these regions, the data sent showed that they had entered an area where the solar wind's influence ceased to be felt almost entirely. Until then, we knew very little about this region. Thanks to the Voyager probes, we realized that it existed. This area is called the termination shock front and is considered the boundary of one of the last outer edges of the Sun's influence. It is a more or less spherical area or region where the solar wind slows down because of the interactions with a local interstellar medium in its path, in the region known as the heliosphere. The termination shock front is situated between 75 and 90 astronomical units from the Sun. However, this is only an approximation, as it expands and contracts due to the changes in the speed and the pressure of the solar wind. Voyager spacecraft ultimately traversed this region in 2005. Next, the heliosheath. The heliosheath is the zone between the termination shock front and the heliopause at the solar system's outer edge. It extends along the edge of the heliosphere. The distance of the heliosheath from the Sun is about 80 or 100 astronomical units. The current mission of the Voyager 1 and 2 space probes includes the study of the heliosheath, and both have already crossed this area as well. next we come to the heliopause. It is when the solar wind binds to the interstellar medium, or the stellar wind coming from other stars. It is considered to be the boundary of the heliosphere and the beginning of interstellar space. Currently, the Voyager probes have already exceeded the space limit as well. So in correct terms, you could say that the Voyager spacecraft are already outside the limits of solar radiation. Still, we are not done yet, after the heliopause follows even more layers. Next, we have the bow shock. Just as there is an area where the solar wind ends, there is a region where the solar radiation is entirely no longer felt and begins to dominate the radiation coming from the interstellar medium. This region is known as bow shock and is an arc-shaped region that extends to the front of the solar system as it travels around the galaxy. All stars are thought to have a bow shock that extends around each star, giving them an elongated shape like a comet. This would mean that the bow shock surrounding the solar system is not spherical, but somewhat elongated, like a drop of water or comet. And its main responsibility is protecting us from cosmic rays from other galaxies or the center of our own galaxy. Cosmic rays come from super-powerful events in the universe, such as the supernova or quasars that are so energetic that they could end all life on Earth in an instant. Thanks to the bow shock that surrounds the solar system, radiation does not reach the Earth with such intensity, and we can be safe. The Voyager probes have not yet fully traversed this region of the solar system. And finally, we have the Oort Cloud, the limit of the solar system. This is a spherical cloud of trans-Neptunian objects, which are comets and asteroids beyond Neptune's orbit that lies at the edges of the solar system, almost a light year from the Sun, and surrounds the entire solar system like a massive sphere of asteroids. In previous videos, we've discussed this region in much more detail. Astronomers believe that long-period comets come from this area. The Oort Cloud is thought to extend from the 2000s to the Sun's 50,000 astronomical units. The Oort Cloud can also be divided into two regions. The outer Oort Cloud, between 20,000 and 50,000 astronomical units, spherical in shape, and the inner Oort Cloud, which is between 2,000 and 20,000 astronomical units, has a toroidal shape. The outer cloud is not very bound to the Sun, and is the source of most of the long-period comets, such as the Halley's Comet. The inner cloud is also known as the Hills Cloud, after Jack G. Hills, the astronomer who proposed its existence in 1981. Models predict that the inner cloud should possess tens or hundreds of times more objects than the outer cloud. It appears that the Hills Cloud replenishes the outer cloud with comets as they become depleted, and explains the Oort Cloud's existence after billions of years. It is believed that the Oort Cloud may host several trillion bodies over 1.3 kilometers in diameter. Despite the high number of bodies, each would be separated by several tens of millions of kilometers from the nearest one, so it is almost impossible for any of the Voyager spacecraft to collide with any of these bodies. The mass of the Oort Cloud is not known for sure, but if Halley's Comet is taken as a prototype outer cloud object, it is estimated that the mass would be 3 times 1,025 kilograms, that is, 5 times the mass of Earth. Astronomers consider the boundary of this region to be the actual end of the solar system, and it is only when the Voyager spacecraft completely traverse the Oort Cloud that we could declare that in effect the Voyager probes have wholly exited the solar system and the force of attraction of the Sun. So in conclusion, the Voyager space exploration probes have traveled hundreds of millions of kilometers in space since they were launched almost 50 years ago. They are the objects created by humanity that have gone the furthest, and thanks to them, we know the interstellar medium better. Currently, both spacecraft have exceeded the limits of the heliopause. So, it is correct to say that they are outside the limits of the solar system. However, both Voyager 1 and 2 are still under the effects of the gravitational attraction from the Sun. The Oort Cloud measures approximately 50,000 astronomical units, and at the speed that both spacecraft are moving, it will take them between 14,000 and 28,000 years to traverse the entire region. That is to say, until then, we will be able to assure with total certainty that the Voyager spacecraft will have left the solar system entirely within 14,000 years. By then, the human race would no longer exist. Perhaps we would have developed technology so fast that we could catch up with and even surpass the Voyager spacecraft before they left the solar system. For now though, the Voyager probes still have a long way to go. Meanwhile, they continue to send us information that reveals mysteries and amazing discoveries of the furthest limits of the solar system in which we live. For a long time, the exact nature of the place outside our solar system had been a complete mystery. Still, thanks to the Voyagers, we're receiving data that allows us to understand better what's out there and what lies ahead for future generations who decide to venture beyond the far reaches of the solar system. And when the human race has left the Earth, the Voyager probes will continue to travel eternally to the ends of the universe. One day, a race of aliens will likely find them and realize that in that small solar system made up of a star and eight planets, there was a race of tiny beings that walked on two legs and that they had managed to develop an advanced technology that helped them survive the violent changes of the universe and venture beyond their star.